Hello friends, in this video we will learn about subject verb agreement. Before learning about subject verb agreement, first of all we will know about subjects and verbs. What is a subject? The subject is that noun that is doing or being something. The noun is the name of a place, person or a thing. What is a verb? Verbs are the action words in a sentence that describe what the subject is doing. Verbs are basically action words. Now, how will you identify the subject in any sentence? To identify a subject, ask who is performing. And to identify verb, ask what is performed by the subject. Now see some examples. First, Sneha is playing chess. So, who is performing? Sneha is performing. So, Sneha is the subject. And what is performed by the subject? That is play. So, play is verb. Next sentence. The dogs are barking. So, who is doing action? The dogs. So, dog is the subject. And what are they doing? They are barking. So, barking is the verb. Based on the point of view, subjects are of three types. First person, second person and third person. Who are first person? The person who is speaking. I and we are the words used for first person. Second person, who is listening? That is you. And the third person, about whom we are talking about. For example, he, she, it, they. On the basis of counting, subjects can be singular or plural. Now, what is the meaning of subject verb agreement? For a sentence to be grammatically correct, it needs to satisfy some of the rules. Subject verb agreement simply means that the subject and verb must agree in number. This means that either both need to be singular or both need to be plural. That is, a singular subject must have a singular verb and a plural subject must have a plural verb. This is the most basic rule of subject verb agreement. This is a rule for the subject is third person. If the subject is first or second person, then the rule doesn't apply. Let us see some examples when the subject is singular. So, our first sentence is, he plays football. Here, the word he is singular and the verb is also singular, that is plays. We use s with singular. Let us see second example. She reads a book. Here, the word she, that is subject, is singular and reads is the verb, is also singular. Now let us see some examples where subject is plural. They play football. Here they is plural and we have also used the plural verb, that is play. Now second example, they read a book. Here they is plural subject and read is also a plural verb. These examples were following the rule of singular subject with singular verb and plural subject with plural verb. Since the subject was third person, now let us see some example where the subject is first or second person and not the third person. First example, I play football. Here I is first person, that is singular. and play is the plural verb. Let us see second example. We play football. Here we is plural subject and play is plural verb. That is, this is not following the rule of singular subject with singular verb and plural subject with plural verb, since the rule always follow when the subject is third person. For first or second person, the rule doesn't follow. So, what we will do in case of subject being first or second person? There are some rules of subject verb agreement that I will discuss in my next video. Now, we will revise what we have learned in this video. First, we learned how to identify subject and verbs. To identify subject, we will ask who is performing. And to identify verb, we will ask what is performed by the subject. Next, we learned the meaning of subject verb agreement. Subject verb agreement means that the subject and verb must agree in number. That is, when the subject is third person, either both need to be singular, that is singular subject with singular verb, or both need to be plural, that is plural subject need to have a plural verb. Then we saw some examples when the subject is singular. If the subject was singular, the verb will also be singular. Then we read examples where the subject is plural. If the subject was plural, then the verb will also be plural. Thanks for watching the video. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends.